Hi, today I want to talk about a multimeter, the VC70B Plus. And as you might see before, I've also have a Fluke 70B Plus, so I think we can compare the both together. And as you might see, also the look and feel are a little bit similar. So we can open the box and can see what's inside. And I've ordered for a comparison in different colors, so it's not really a one. And we can obviously see in our comparison the difference between the two. And we also get a small data sheet or what have you, and some leads. We can compare the leads, and we also get a K-type thermal couple. So first see the obvious difference. So the range switch are very similar. We have the AC range, then we have the DC range, we have millivolts, we have ohms, and also diode checking and some beeper. We have the capacitors, amp range, milliamp range, microamp range, and also similar, we have the both of the temperature range. So the other switches are a little bit different. So we have here a select switch that is not marked on the Fluke, but it's also an orange button. We have a hold button here. That's also the backlight. Here we have an extra switch for the backlight and a relative button, a range switch, and also a min-max button. And also the position of the lead plugs are very similar. So let's see the back side. The back side we have also some positioning for the leads. We have a holder for maybe if you want to hold it on your belt. We have a tilting belt. Here on the Fluke we have it integrated to the battery case. And on the ZOYI, I cannot open this, so let's do it. This, the tilting bail is attached to the rubber casing, so it's a little bit different. And also to open the battery compartment, we have to use on the Fluke a special tool. So we use a small coin to open this. So like this. And also, as you see, you can open this and the battery connectors are inside the case, and the tilting bail is attached to the case holder. And let's remove the batteries. So here we have two connectors, and for the ZOYI we have to open it with a screwdriver. So let's do it. And as in comparison, so it looks very similar to the Fluke. And also we have two AA batteries that fits in the compartment, so we can say this is similar. And maybe the look and feel, the Fluke is very rigid, and also the ZOYI are very stiff and rigid. So let's put it out of the rubber compartment, and we can first compare the rubber outer. So let's remove this, and as you see, there are some minor difference, but from the form and size factor they're very similar. So let's compare the meters. As you see, the size is nearly the same. No, it's nearly the same height and width, and also the lengths are very similar, as you see. So, but I think the most important part is how it looks inside. So let's take off the screws and we see what's inside both of the meters. So we have very small screws on the ZOYI. So 1, 2, 3 screws, and this is self-tapping screws, so there's no metal threaded insert. This is just straight to the plastic case. So if we take the screws several times out, maybe they don't screw anymore. So, and let's do the same on the Fluke. First this screws, and they are also screwed inside the plastic case, but they are, compared to the other screws, much more meat. So also we take 4 screws out and let's see what's inside. So now we can reveal. No, in the Fluke we have also 2 more screws. So in total on the Fluke we have 6 screws to take out before we can open the case. So don't lose the screws, but we have very large area in the case that's overlapping with the outside, so we have a bigger protection. Here are the battery connectors with a spring-loaded type, and as you see, very nicely built. So now the other, we have also very big overlapping, that's nice. So the big difference, the battery holders are soldered to the board, and now we see the big difference. So we have HRC fuses, 2 on the Fluke, and here we have only glass fuses, very small glass fuses. And big surprise. Okay, first let's do the obvious thing. Here we have the current shunt for the small ampere, the milliampere range. So I don't see the current shunt for the, here on the Fluke it's obvious this is the current shunt for the 10 ampere range, and here maybe they used the diodes as a current shunt, I don't know. So this is, here we see the plugs are tapped with screws to the case, and here we have just soldered some leads to the banana plugs. So, and I think what we are missing is, so here we have the in, here we connect, as mentioned here, cat 3000 volts to this plug, and then it goes to nowhere. So I think we need to further remove some screws to see where the 1000 volts goes. 1, 2, so more screws here. So I broke this already, no problem. Now we can take out the whole PCB and have a look what's going on. So last screw. So as you see, here we go with our 1000 volts, and then the whole 1000 volts goes to the range switch. What a surprise. No protection, no MOFs, no PTC or NTC, no big resistor that protects us from anything. No, the whole volt goes to the range switch. So in my opinion, this is no protection at all. So The fuse is at thousands volts, so I think you don't only destroy your meter, risk a very big shock from this, so this is not so good. So on the backside there's nothing, and as you see, all we have here is a big blob that is doing all the thing. Here we have a zebra strip to the LCD, and we have the carbon coated switches here, or push buttons, and the big range switch here with the spring loaded contacts. That's all. So no more to say about this. I think there's no protection, so don't use this, and maybe higher voltage than maybe 80 volts, that's okay, but everything higher, that is very, don't use this at main voltage, so this is very dangerous. So now I put it together and show you the functions. So let's continue our comparison. First I insert the batteries, and I do this like this, two AA batteries, and sorry, they are different manufacturers, but I think we can use this. So like so, and now we can switch them on both together. So let's first do the first test. So, and the first thing we see, the very obvious, our Fluke LCD is very sharp, and this is very dim, and even from an angle I can not really see this very well. So the difference is we have this claims to be a true RMS AC voltage range, and on the Fluke we have no true RMS. This is the main difference. Now let's see the DC range, also very similar, and also the display is very similar. Next we have our millivolt range. So next we have our ohm range. With the select button we can go to the continuity mode, and next we go to the, and also here we have a diode test. So ohms range, then the continuity mode, and also the diode mode. So next we have our capacity testing. Here we have microfarad, and here we have nanofarad, but I think this is just the range. Maybe we can switch between the ranges, I don't know. So let's continue with amps, and I already have a problem. So we cannot switch to the amp range. So maybe it's already broken, the new device. So, okay, we do another comparison. We compare the new ZOYI leads, and this claims to be 600 volt 10 amps. So we have here a 20 amp range and only 10 amp leads. And as we compare them with the Fluke leads, we have very thick leads, and they are cat 2000 volts for 10 amps. And this is a little bit crappier on the ZOYI meter. So maybe I go to continuity mode on both and let's compare them. So this is also very crappy. So we have already a problem here, or we go to the diode testing here and let's see the diode voltage 3.2 volts and if we do this in the opposite side. On the Fluke we have 2.3 volts. So that's all for today, and if you have some comments or some suggestions how I can activate the amps range and so forth in the ZOYI meter or do the continuity mode a little bit better, so write it in the comments. Thank you, have a nice day and bye bye.